Hello everyone, and peace of Christ all of you. Please invite your friends and share the link if you like. There's three Muslims in the last 4 days. They keep posting in the comment section. They're trying to prove that Jesus, which the Old Testament prophesy about, is not Christ. I can finish this video in 2 seconds. Literally, in 2 seconds. But just to show you the stupidity when you follow Muhammad. So when a Muslim, he is trying his best to prove to me that Jesus is not a Christ. Didn't you just prove to me that Muhammad is not a prophet? Because isn't it your stupid Quran says that this is a Christ? So 3 days non-stop of a stupid comment can be killed and destroyed in 2 seconds. Because guess what? You just said to me that everything in the Quran about the Son of Mary, who is the Christ, is a lie. I mean, this is how stupid they are. So if I go now with your argument, which is silly and stupid, and I say, okay, you know what? You are a winner. You are right. But you just destroyed your prophet. Is that your book, or this is the book of the Hindu? Behold, the angel said to Mary, Allah give thee glad tiding of a word from him. His name will be, not will be actually, there's no will be in the Arabic. His name is Christ Jesus. So 4 days non-stop arguing in a stupid comment, trying to prove to us that the Messiah is not Jesus. Because when you say Jesus did not fulfill the prophecy about Christ, you are saying that Jesus is not a Christ. As simple as that. Three people in the comment section, they joined together to prove a point. So we killed the argument in 2 seconds, and thank you very much for proving that Muhammad, because for me, at the end of the day, you are helping me, proving to me that Muhammad is a fraud. And here we go. Finally, you come to a conclusion that your prophet is a liar. Whatever he say about Jesus in his Quran is a fraud. Now, if we go to the comment, as an example, this person, he's a Muslim, he called himself Jason. I don't know why. Look what he said. If you remember yesterday, we spoke about the book of Psalm, chapter 91. He said, okay, Psalm 91, 1 to 9 is about God people, but Psalm 91, 10, 16 refer to Jesus, this context. In Matthew 4, 6, 7, chapter 4, from 6 to 7. Here is Satan tested Jesus. You know, just to show you again how stupid they are. You are trying to prove to me that Jesus will be protected, or he will not be protected. Let us say you are saying he will be protected. All right. But you just admitted, you idiot, that this is refer to Jesus' conversation. And in the previous text you said, Jesus, he did not say, did not say that. He agreed. But did Jesus say to him, I am not the Son of God? If you are the Son of God, he said, throw yourself down from, for it is written. So you just agreed that Jesus, and the Muslim, they say to us, where Jesus says, I am Son of God. Or where he said, I am God. So as long as you agree with this verse, we'll agree with the verse. Secondly, you idiot. You said you did read interpretation. Well, here we go. This is the interpretation in front of us. There's tons of verses about protecting believers. You see it? All those verses. And this is what Jesus said to him, don't test your Lord, your God, as you tested him at the Messiah, at the Mashiach. So, Satan, he is quoting for him from the Old Testament. Is it doesn't say this? I will give you an example just for your foolishness. In Mark 16:8, it says, they shall take up a serpent, and if they drink any deadly thing, it shall not hurt them. They shall lay down, they shall lay hand on the sick and shall recover. What does that mean, that I can drink now poison and nothing will kill me? Does that mean I can go to a place full of corona and I will not die? All the disciples of Jesus and Jesus himself were killed. So the protection of God is about what? I mean, when somebody says something, it's really weird. It can be about an individual or it's about everybody. However, not a single individual from those who mention in the Bible, especially the disciple of Jesus, were not killed. And Jesus himself, all the Christians agree that he was killed. So to say that the prophecy speaking about Jesus will protect it, well, I mean, Jesus will not be need to be protected by the angels. The angels, they came to serve him, for he is God. But he do not need the protection of anyone. Actually, when Peter, he tried to protect Jesus by using his sword, Jesus ordered him to put down his sword, refusing anyone to intervene. So, and Jesus knew when they are going to come, and they are going to arrest him, and who is going to betray him, and what they will say, even the word by word, and what time they will come, etc. So he can just run, you know, he can take a horse and go. I mean, if I know my enemy is coming to get me now, and I want to save myself, if this is the plan, the easiest thing, before they come, I will leave, and that's it. At that time, there is no cell phone to track you, or, you know, that's it. Just leave the house. Go out of town where nobody know you, where your, you know, like old days, a scarf in your face, the one they use for dust. It's like a mask and nobody will notice who you are. So the verses is not talking about what people try to claim. Like you will see somebody, a Muslim, saying, oh, here we go, I will give you a poison, drink it, and you will not die. Muhammad, he said, if you eat 7 ajwa, that was literally about eating ajwa, that will not hurt you, and no poison will kill you. But Muhammad himself, later, he died by poison, proving that he is a false man. So what about this verse here? Is it really, snake cannot kill us with their poison? Is it true if we drink poison, nothing will happen to us? Obviously, there is one of two ways to take it, to take this verse, either literally or metaphorically. However, in the book of Acts, as you see here, this is the Jewish Orthodox Bible. In the book of Acts, it's mentioned for us the story of how a snake and how a poison could not hurt Shaul, as you see. So it can be about individual, it can be literally, it can be metaphorically, but all of us, we knew that Christians, they die, apostles, they were killed, they were crucified. The Messiah himself, that's what the Christian believe is, himself was killed. So anything else, this is your own interpretation. So when a Muslim, he try his best to prove a point, he help us very much to prove a good point. And what is the good point is? That a Muslim, when he tried to prove that Jesus was not crucified, he have to agree that Jesus is God. Because look what you are trying to say to me. You are trying to say to me that Jesus have a protection of God and nobody can kill him. In the same time, you as a Muslim, we find you agree that Muhammad, who is the most favorite person to God according to Muslims, he was killed by poison. We just showed you a verse about Paul and how poison did not affect him. And how now we show you your prophet himself admitting that he is dying by poison. And then here we need to ask ourselves, how come if Allah is the God of Isa and he is the God of Muhammad, and if Muhammad is his favorite man, how come Allah don't want to save Muhammad, his favorite, yet he is saving Jesus, who is not his favorite? Croatian saying, maybe the poison mean false teaching. This is what I said. I said it can be metaphorically, it can be physically, you know. However, physically, all of us, we knew that I'm a believer, still I will die by poison. And physically, all of us, we knew that all the disciples of Christ were killed and Christ himself was killed. So Christian does not claim that if you believe in Jesus, actually Jesus himself, he said, time will come and people will think by killing you, they are doing favor to God. This is the word of Jesus himself. He predicted before they start killing them that you will be killed because of me. All right? But look now, we are comparing. A Muslim trying to prove to us that Jesus is protected. In the same time, other comment, Muslims are trying to say Jesus did not fulfill the Bible, which means they are saying Jesus is not Christ, but the Quran says Jesus is Christ. So the foolishness of Muslims, which is beyond imagination sometimes, they are blinded with hate against Christianity to the point they are willing to say anything, even if it's against their own religion. As we showed you, well, Jesus, obviously for them, he did not fulfill the Bible. And as long as he did not fulfill the prophecy about Christ, well, he isn't a Christ then. And then you will find another Muslim saying the following. And actually, before we go there, you will see there's tons of verses speaking about Jesus and every believer. As an example here, it is written, he will command the angels concerning you to guard you carefully. Is that specifically about Jesus? We will see later. And they will lift you up with their hands so they will not strike you. Luke 4:11. Are not the angels ministering spirit sent to serve those who will inherit salvation? Jesus will inherit salvation, for he is the salvation. He guard his the step of his faithful ones, but the wicked perish in darkness. Is that only for Jesus or for everyone? I'm just showing you your stupidity and your ignorance in the Bible. The angel of the Lord will protect and be around those who fear him and deliver them. Is that for Jesus or for everybody? You see, the same book you are talking about, Psalm. Bless the Lord, all his angels mighty in strength, who do his words, anyone who do his words. I mean, the verses is all over, and you idiot, you are coming to me to say this statement. However, as long as you are quoting for me the book of Psalm to prove to me that Jesus should not be killed and should not be and he should be protected from being killed, well, I don't know how stupid you are, because you forgot in the same book, Psalm 22, there is the most strong argument Christians they have against the Jews when they say or they claim that Jesus is not the one who is the Messiah. Isn't it? This is the book of the Old Testament. And isn't it? This is about Jesus. And this is what Jesus, he quote in the cross. Eli, Eli. He was quoting the book of Psalm. Many Christians do not know especially if they are young ones, they don't know like why Jesus he said Eli Eli, you know, though why are you forsaking me? He was quoting the book of Psalm, saying the prophecy you heard there is about me. This is why he quoted. And why he quoted this specific chapter? He's talking about his crucifixion. The same book you are trying to prove that Jesus was not crucified. Huh? So what we will do with this chapter now? We are going to delete it just to make you happy because you are a happy Abdul. All right? So when a Muslim he tried to say something, I find it an embarrassment, stupid, dummy, and desperate. Very desperate. Do we have any comment from the Muslims community? Any comment? All right. And we know that there's tons of prophecies about Jesus. And at the end of the day, you Abdul, I mean, you Abdul, you say to us, suddenly you became expert in the Bible. But we laugh about your expertise because you cannot explain one verse for us in the Quran. And if Jesus will be protected, that is more problem for you, actually, from Jesus being crucified. And I will explain to you easier. Actually, already we mentioned that Muhammad, he was killed by poison. So I have a question for you. Please leave the answer for me in the comment section. Why Allah protected Jesus and he made a big plan? Cloning someone like Jesus. People see Jesus in the cross. He lied to people about Jesus. They saw Jesus, but it's not Jesus. But it was Jesus who looked like Jesus, but Jesus is not Jesus. So it's not Jesus who was on Jesus. And Jesus is not Jesus anymore because Jesus was in the cross. It's not the same Jesus, which was Jesus. So now we do not know who is Jesus because Allah, he cloned Jesus. So now we have two Jesus. And which Jesus was on the cross, we all only Allah knows best. And the most stupid story ever. So why Allah did not make Muhammad look like Muhammad and stomach like the stomach of Muhammad? So when they put a poison for Muhammad, the stomach of the fake Muhammad died. What do you think? Here we go. We have Muhammad is being by the same people, the Jews. The Jews again. The Jews, they want to kill Jesus. The Jews, they want to kill Isa. Sorry, Muhammad. Okay. So Allah want to save Jesus. So he cloned Jesus. He makes someone look like Jesus, but it's not Jesus. So the Jews, they saw Jesus, but this is not Jesus. And he spoke to Jesus, but this was not Jesus. He had the voice of Jesus, but it's not Jesus. He had the ear of Jesus, but it's not Jesus. He had the eyes of Jesus. Even his mother, she saw Jesus, but this is not was just not Jesus. So now we have Jesus in the cross. It's not the same as Jesus who ran away to heaven. And now we have two Jesus, one in the earth, and he became in the grave. And one Jesus is in heaven, the real Jesus in heaven, the dead Jesus is not. This is what you say to us. So why Allah did not make Muhammad like Muhammad? So when Muhammad he eat the goat which have poison, the stomach of the fake Muhammad will eat the poison, and then the fake stomach of Muhammad and Muhammad, that real Muhammad, will not be hurt. So the fake stomach will eat it and will be poisoned, and Muhammad the fake will die, not the real Muhammad. I mean, have you ever heard of a stupidity more than this? So what you are saying to us, that Jesus is God again. Because Jesus, nothing can kill him. This is what you are saying to me. I mean, when you try to deny that Jesus was killed, you just approve again that Jesus is even more. This is, will be a good argument for the Christians. Okay, thank you. Jesus, no, nothing, nobody can kill him. Everybody die, brother, except Jesus in heaven. I mean, what does that mean? Are we going to add this to the list of the amazing things about Jesus? Yes, we can. Jesus have no father. They will say to you, Adam had no father. Are you a stupid donkey? How Adam will have a father if he is the first man? Stupidity. Jesus is the only one who have no father. Jesus is the only one is son of virgin. Jesus is the only one who spoke in the credo. Jesus is the only one who can, in Islam, who can make the dead come from the grave. He can tell you what you hide, which means he can see the unseen. And this is only for God. He can create from the mother bird. Only Jesus, he can heal anything, anyone. I mean, there is a long list of the miracles of Jesus in the Quran, and Muhammad have zero. The only miracles you will see Muhammad have is after he died, the Muslims, they start fabricating hadith, saying Muhammad have miracles. And now here we see that Muhammad is dying by poison and Allah is not saving Muhammad. Why? Why Allah is saving Jesus, but he don't want to save Muhammad? In the previous quote, if you remember, a Muslim, he quote for me from the book of Isaiah, and he says this is Jesus did not fulfill because simply the sheep will sleep next to the lion or the wolf, etc., and the world will be different. And he said this is not about judgment day. It says later day in different translation. You skip it. It says there he will judge all mankind, all nations. Jesus will judge all mankind, all nations. And look what you did. You just proved to me that your prophet again is a false prophet. Because if this is will happen in the first coming of Jesus, that means Muhammad is a liar. Isn't it your prophet that said that the second coming of Jesus, he will be a just ruler? Are you saying your prophet, he did lie? Let us see. I'm just showing you, and this is why I call this video The Three Fools. You know, I mean, I was going to add the three fools, but I want them to come. But in fact, those are three fools helping us. So if Jesus will rule the world in the first coming, and this is what the guy, his name is Mu, I could not find the comment. I think it was in the previous video, which I deleted. And by the way, he said to me, why you deleted those videos? You deleted 10 years of your life, my friend. Your God, he deleted, actually the goat, she deleted the verses of adult breastfeeding. How much time took Allah? For me, I deleted my videos because YouTube is after me. But however, you can find all my videos. I keep encouraging people to download it right away. Look what your stupid prophet said. Did I say stupid? Sorry for insulting the stupid one. By him, in whose my hand, my life, the son of Mary will come soon. In fact, it doesn't say he will come soon. In fact, it says Yushik, which means almost. Almost there. If I lose my internet, please let me know. And I will give you an example about Muslim argument, how stupid it is. So, the guy whose name is Mo Money, who said, Jesus, this is not about Jesus in the first coming, this is not in the last coming, this is in the first coming. It says there he will judge. And your prophet confirming that. So your prophet obviously is a liar again. And as you see, this is a Sahih Hadith. Each time a Muslim, he tried to come with an argument. Sorry, my voice is tired. Actually, I wasn't planning to come today, but I said, let me make a short video. And this is supposed to be a short video. How long we are here now? Is Abbas is here? Abbas is here? I see somebody saying Abbas. Don't remind me of Abbas. I mean, those Muslims, they have no idea what Islam is about. And always they contradict them, their own words, their own teaching. And in order to fight Christianity, they are willing to spank their prophet harshly. As simple as that. I want to remind Muslims to leave a comment for me. Why Allah, He protected Jesus, but He did not protect Muhammad? This is a very important question. We want an answer. And actually, I saw some Muslims, like there is a girl, her name is Fifi, she said, oh, the Prophet said, I think it was Fifi who said that, I'm not, I remember, I think so, you can confirm to me. The Prophet, when he said that the poison, he was guessing. The Prophet is wrong? Suddenly the Prophet is wrong. I feel, okay, Christian Prince, does it say there, I feel as? Did you see the word as? Hello? Look, let me show you. Let me get you busted. It says in English here, I feel as. So it's not. It says as. may Allah as you. Literally. It doesn't say as. In Arabic it says فَهَذَا أَوَانُ وَجَدْتُمْ قِطَاعَ أَبْهَرِي. I found that my aorta is cut from that poison. There is no as in Arabic. But even if we take it as, so is your prophet making a false statement? Either you have to agree that your prophet, he knew what he's talking about, and he is inspired by God, and he knew what is the cause of death, and what is killing him, or you have to agree that Muhammad is an ignorant man, he have no idea what he's saying. Choose one. Either one you choose is horrible for you as a Muslim. I think we have one more comment, let us see, before... If you remember, you know, Muslims always, they come with a funny argument. Like one day, Abbas, who was in the chat, he called me, I remember, and he said, Mary is not part of the Trinity in Islam. There is nowhere in the Quran it says that. You remember, Abbas? Guys, hold on. Let me show you what Abbas is saying. This hadith is known from a tabi'i called Zuhri ibn Hisham, who was known as a mudallis, which means a liar. I mean, you Muslims are the most funny idiot ever when it's come to Islam. Look how stupid you are. So he is a mudallis, and this hadith in Sahih Bukhari. Guys, this guy is a liar. The one who reported the hadith. He's a liar. He's a liar, brother. So, are you saying to me a fabricated hadith is located in Sahih al-Bukhari? This is the most authentic book. It's called Sahih al-Bukhari. It's called the authentic Bukhari. So in the authentic Bukhari, there's liars. So al-Bukhari, he spent his life, and the Muslims adore him as if he's God. And they agree that his book is the most authentic. And now the guy is a liar. Anyway, Abbas is my favorite entertaining. Once I was driving my car, and then I opened YouTube, like, you know, I was in the traffic light, and then the video of Abbas came. Like, you know, YouTube suggests videos for you. And the video was about uh, What was the title? It was from Suku Film. Oh, When Abbas Debate Christian Prince, Best Bites. Yeah, remember. Do you want me to remind you a little bit, Abbas? I mean, this guy, he got humiliated. I think they are addicted with spanking. I think they have addiction in spanking, or spanking addiction. Unbelievable. Anything is an embarrassment for them. They say the one who wrote the hadith is a liar. Okay, what about the Quran? What about the Quran? The Quran said, the Quran said, now they will say it's weak, that Allah said to Shaitan, Inna ibadi laysa laka alayhim sultan illa man ittaba'aka min al-ghawin. My servants, you have no authority over them except who follow you from the criminals. Okay, that's good. So Allah, he promised that Shaitan have no authority over anyone from the Muslims, and he have authority only over the criminals. Actually, a translation here is not accurate. It says, when you say Al-Ghawin is somebody, he's doing big crimes. See, we change the translation suddenly, it's different. Quran is free from error. Well, do you remember, Abbas, when you said to me that there is nowhere in the Quran says that the Trinity is Mary and Jesus and Allah? Is that an error or not? And then I got you busted? Do you remember? So if Allah is saying that Shaitan have no authority over my followers, so then how Muhammad became a sinner? How a person became a sinner? Isn't it Shaitan who mislead you and make you a sinner? Right? Muhammad is a sinner in the Quran. Isn't it Muslims, they agree that Shaitan? He throws satanic verses in Muhammad's mouth. In chapter 47, verse number 19, Allah is saying to Muhammad, and look, the Muslims here, they translate falsely, says, ask for the forgiveness forgiveness of their fault. What fault? It's sin, dhanb. It is dhanb. Change the translation. Right away you will see the word is different. Is it fault really? Or it is sin? See? It's sin. Ask Allah for forgiveness of your sin and their sin. So how Shaitan have no authority over those who follow Allah, except those who they are criminals, and then people commit sin? Isn't it sin? Is you being deceived, tempted by the devil to do bad? And this is what the Quran confirms in many places. In Arabic, Christ is Isa. In Arabic, in the Quran, but in the Bible, you mean? Yeshua, which is the same as Yeshua. We never heard of Isa. Arab Christian, we never heard of this guy. His name is Isa. Who's Isa? We have no idea. But the only explanation that Maryam, the sister of Aaron, she have a son. His name is Isa, or Iso. And the stupid Muhammad, he thought that Maryam, the sister of Aaron, is the mother of Jesus. And this is why in different verse in the Quran, Muhammad, he said, claiming that Mary, she is the sister of Aaron. which is very funny and very stupid. Chapter 19, verse number 28. And then the Muslim here, they will try to say to you, oh, no, 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 no. In that time, they used to call them by their great ancestors or prophet. First of all, she is Mary. She is not from the same tribe of Aaron. Secondly, why Aaron? Number three, if you go to chapter 3, you will find the chapter name is Al Imran. Chapter 3 in the Quran, it's called Al Imran. Who is Imran? According to Muhammad, this is the father of Mary. The family of Imran, you see it? Go right now and search in Prophet Google, peace upon him. Who is the father of Moses in Islam? The same name, Imran. So the foolish Muhammad, obviously, the proof is overwhelming, that he thought that Imran is the father of Mary, the father of Aaron, the father of Moses, and Isa, which is the son of Mary, he is Isa. This is how dumb this cult is. Anyway, I'm not going to keep you longer. Any other question? I think we missed one post. Let me check. Hold on. Yeah, hold on. There is a little bit missing. I took a screenshot of those posts. The one I was able to find. We answered this one actually, but we did not show the post. So this guy here in his post, let us show you the screen. He said the Christian boy doesn't say in the last days, but later days or days come after. We just showed you that you are an idiot because your prophet, he says Jesus will come in the last days and he will rule. He will rule the whole world. So you are against what your prophet said. Secondly, when you say it doesn't say the last days, it says later days. Let us see what the verses are saying. I mean, it says the last days. It shall come and pass in the last days. Now we can change the translation, no problem. But what the last days will happen? I mean, the later days, what later days? Is that a judgment day? Absolutely. Verse number 4, it says, and he shall judge among the nations, all nations. Do you see it? So you are foolish again. And again, this is against, you are attacking your prophet. For your prophet is the one who said that Jesus will come down, and this is the second coming. And was Muhammad here predicting that Jesus will come as very soon, and this is the judgment day? Yes. And this is again a proof that Muhammad is a false prophet. Because he said the Yushika, almost there. And this was 1400 years ago, false prophecy. And, here you will notice something funny about Muhammad, saying that Jesus, he will have a cowboy fight with the pig. He will have what? A cowboy fight with the pig. What? I did not get it. What is the connection between Jesus coming back, making justice happen, and Mr. Pig? Can you tell me? Where is the... Let us see. Jesus is coming. He is from one side, and the pig is in the other side. It's happening. Pig is going to withdraw his gun. Oh boy. Ugh. That's not happening. No way. The pig. Look, watch his hand. Oh, Isa, be careful. Pig is going to withdraw. Be careful. Very good news. Isa, he shot the pig. The pig he injured, and he is in the ground. I mean, how silly you can be and how stupid you are. Pig, Christ will come from the seven. This is the plan of God. He will send Isa to fight with the pig, and he will kill the pig. Which pig? The one who have sex with 6 years old girl? Which one deserves to die more? But anyway, it was very exciting to watch this compact, guns fight between Isa and I like it. Very interesting. Yeah, true. Yeah, that's it. And the funny, he will say he will apologize to jizya. Who pay jizya anymore? Isa will come and apologize to jizya. Nobody pay jizya. Where do we pay jizya? Which country Christians are paying jizya? Nobody paying jizya. So this is a false. According to this, jizya will stay until the judgment day. But no Christians are paying. It's Muslims who pay jizya. Trump, he forced you to buy his weapon. He forced you to send your money. He forced you to make agreement. He forced you to make contract. He forced you to buy things you do not even need. Just to make him happy. What jizya? I think we have one more comment left. Just give me a second. Maybe I don't know if we finish or not. Actually we answer all of them. Anyway, I want to say thank you guys for being here. This is just a good morning video. We the Christians, we are victorious by the truth, and the truth will set you free. A foolish man, he don't speak wisdom. And we hear nothing from Muhammad except foolishness. Shaitan, he fart when they pray. Allah will make your face a face of a donkey if you raise your head before the imam. Allah will make you a pig and a monkey if you drink wine, but yet he was a drunken person all his life. He's a fornicator. I mean, all the crimes in the world, all the words can be considered crimes. In the book of crimes, Muhammad, he did. And yet he was teaching you not to drink, brother. Don't drink. We are decent people. And don't look at women who they are not yours. But when Muhammad, he see your wife, you have to divorce her so he can have her and do boom boom to her. He's decent. When Muhammad, he sit in front of his house, he never look at women because he's very decent. Yet, when a woman, she walk by and she have a nice bum, Muhammad, he got so horny to the point he cannot wait. So he went to his wife and she was tanning leather. And he started doing boom boom to her like a beast. any human behavior. A woman, she walked by. A woman, she walked by. What made Muhammad go to his wife? A woman, she walked by. And then Muhammad, he accused that women, they are the devil. They come in the shape of a devil and they live in the shape of the devil. Do you see even, I mean, how shameful this cult is. They are proud about their prophet that he saw a woman. He saw what? He saw a woman. So what happened? He went to his wife and lift up her and he started doing and his wife, she said to him, like, what's wrong with you? Like, don't you see what I'm doing? I mean, you imagine a woman, she is tanning leather, how she will look, how she smell. She have boiling water, she have the color which is coloring. I mean, the guy, that's it, he's a decent man. He's decent. And then after he finished, he accused the women to be the devil. I mean, the devil. I'm a victim of the devil. You know, yes, we tempted, no problem. But how a prophet of God, who's teaching Muslims morality, he go to his own son wife when the husband is not there, and forget about his son. The Muslim, they will say to you, oh, this is adopted son. That will make it even more horrible. Because you gave your word to a man, saying to him, you are my son, I am your father. And this is why he was allowed to be in the house when the husband is not there. He's been trusted. Can you trust Muhammad? You cannot. So he go to the house of his own adopted son. And the Muslim books, the same as here, they say that the prophet, he flirt with the women, saying to her, praise be to Allah, the one who flipped my heart. So this is prophet of morality, who killed women and raped them before even they leave their house. There's a woman actually I respect a lot. Muhammad, after he'd been victorious, he went to a woman who was from a very decent family. He want to rape her. So he said to her, let me have you. Do you know what the woman she said to Muhammad? And I find this woman very brave. Guess what she said to Muhammad? How a woman like me, she will let a filthy man like you. Let me find the hadith. I'm trying to find it in English. They don't have it. In the website? It should be here. We found it. وَهَلْ تَهِبُ الْمَرْأَى. And is it a woman like me, a queen, will offer herself to a filthy man like you? And look what the Muslim, they translate, ordinary man. Where it says ordinary man? It says a suqa, the trashy, the garbage. The Muslims, and you know, guys, look, she said, he asked her to give herself a marriage. Where did he say to her, I want to marry you? Where? He want to sleep. He want to rape her, and he hit her. You know? And then when he started, when I beat her, she said, I seek refuge with Allah from you, which means he is a devil. And then Muhammad, he got worried. He said, okay, you have sought refuge with one who gave refuge. That's why he don't want to kill her no more. So look at the translation, the false translation. You can take this word right now to the dictionary. And you will see what a suqa mean. You can copy it and take a dictionary. Savage, trashy, garbage, thieves, you know, etc. Very brave women, very brave. Yeah. Anyway, I want to say thank you guys for being here. And I hope our video today, maybe it is short, but it's good enough. And actually, this, I mean, I think this length is good. It's not too long. It's not too short. It's good enough, isn't it? So I hope we learn something good for today. And I pray that knowledge will spread. And you know, our target at the end, you know, how many people will learn? How many of you now can refute Muslims? Give me one if you think you can debate Muslims after watching thousands and thousands of my videos. How many of you think that you have really a lot of information to defeat anyone when I debate you about Islam? Give me one if you think you have the ability to do so. I want to see if our school is working. Because this is not about Christian Prince. Honestly, I'm sick of it. I wish one day I would wake up, I would say, you know what? I don't want to come here no more. Honestly, I mean, it's the most sick thing ever you can do. Every day in the morning, you wake up. When you are drinking your coffee, you are talking about what? About Muhammad. Disgusting. Honestly. But my target is, sooner or later, I will die. Maybe I will be killed. I don't know. But I will leave behind thousands and thousands of videos. Priceless. And we have books translated to all languages. So we will not leave behind a generation of ignorance, as what happened when I came to the internet and I found that people have no idea what Islam is about. So we made a revolution. It is a revolution. And I want you to download the videos, save them, because they might one day be able to make all videos disappear. As you know, YouTube is being terrorist organization like them. ISIS. You will find a video of ISIS, but you will not find my video. They take it down. You will find a video of a guy teaching how to do beheading, and they don't flag him. Me, they take my video down. It's against our guideline. We cannot collect donation no more on YouTube. Why? Because my videos is against their guideline. What guideline? I mean, what I'm doing? I cannot say Muhammad is a false prophet. That is the guideline. I cannot call somebody stupid. So they are fighting us with all the weapon they have. They think if they stop donation, Christian Prince will not come online, because maybe he is coming just to collect donation. Actually, I don't talk about my donation much, even though we get very few. Like, I have 900 subscribers in Patreon, but those, most of them, they are just people who subscribe to be updated. Only few who help us in donation. So if you think that we are here because of that, you are mistaken. I was doing this for years and years before I collected as, you know, just 2 videos ago, I told you that time come and I cannot even fix my heater. I spent the whole winter. When I said that just 2 days ago, you remember? I spent the whole winter, honest to God, freezing to death because the cold here is extremely scary. The electric heater is like nothing. You put it next to your feet, you feel nothing. It's useless. I could not even fix my heater the whole winter. This is how much a human being can go through. But cold, hunger, death threat, all this can come upon us. But there's one thing will not change. You see, we are Middle Eastern. We are the one who is under the occupation of Islam for the last 1400 years. Yet we refuse to accept Muhammad as a prophet. 1400 years under their occupation. That's mean my grandfather to the time of Muhammad, they were heroes. They prefer any kind of humiliation, but not to deny Jesus. And we will never do that. So I hope our videos helping as many as we can. And I cannot wait until I get my book in Chinese translated. I don't know if the person is still working it, but he told me he is. That will be a very good accomplishment. Right? Anyway, we pray to the Lord to protect you all, to keep you in good health and wealth. We pray that we are going to be with him and nothing will make us hesitate to make such a decision. Because the second you make that decision that you are going to be away, then you are by your own. Remember, the Bible doesn't promise you that you will be protected from harm of evil. No, no, you will be harmed. But even being harmed is a blessing for you. Fear not those who destroy your body, but those who destroy your soul. And you are born to die anyway. So why you want to fear anything? And why we are so much attached to this earth? I mean, are we living in heaven? I mean, open your TV, it's disgusting. I avoid actually listening to news because disgusting. This guy here rape a woman, this guy here rape a child, this guy, etc. This guy is a child molester. This guy, he shot people in the coffee shop. This guy, I mean, crazy. Sick. And what make it more sick that those TV stations, they don't give you a good news. I mean, they're a specialty because they knew that interesting news is violent. Rape. They will not show you a guy helping a guy, no. They will not show you a person helping a blind man, no. They will show you only negative news, which will make you depressed. And not only that, they can even lie about the news. If a terrorist, he go with his car over many people, like in Ukraine. How many of you saw CNN talking about Ukraine? Just a few days ago, a guy from Yemen, he went over people in Ukraine to kill as many as he can. Nobody. Why? Because Ukraine is a poor country. If this is happening in America, the whole world will be talking about it. And here you see how perverted the media is. Nothing changed. If you are rich, if you are from a powerful nation, if you have a powerful passport, American get killed, the whole world talk about it. A Ukrainian get killed, so what? Do you see the hypocrisy? What, Ukrainian people or a person in Africa is not a human? And in America, we are the human? The whole world is busy with the Trump election as if he is their president. Joe Biden, he win. They start dancing in London. I mean, how human being is so stupid, man. I mean, what do you have to do with the Trump in USA? What is your business? Just wait, Biden will screw you. I mean, those people are stupid. People getting killed in Ethiopia, nobody talk about it. People getting killed in Nigeria, nobody talk about it. People get, but if something happened in a rich country, the whole world talk about it. I remember when I was in the Middle East, you know, they were in the TV, there's a news about an accident, and more than 40 cars, they hit each other in the highway, but nobody get injured. Okay, yeah. Los Angeles. In the same day, we have a bus full of students, all the students get killed, and never mentioned in the TV. Their own citizen. Because in the Middle East, the news never talk about anything negative happening in their land. Because we are living in heaven. In America, brother. In America, bad things happen. In our countries, it is angel land. No rape in the news in the Middle East. No rape. Nobody raped there. No. No killing. No thieves. It's angel land. But now things are changing because people posting on Facebook, you know. I mean, before they were have a control of what is called media. There's only TV station run by governments or even private, but you cannot post as you wish. Otherwise, they will take you to jail. Now things is out of their hands. And anyone can post using fake name, you know, and post on Facebook something happened in his town or etc. However, you as a believer, you are going to face a lot of challenges. It can be even a death threat. It can be a temptation. It can be, I mean, any. Imagine all bad things. And actually, I learned from my life experience that always those who they are with God are the most to be harmed, not the opposite. Why? Because the devil, he wants you to believe that God is not there to protect you. Where is your God? Isn't this what they say to Jesus on the cross? Let your father take you down. Where is your father? Where is your father? So the evil will try to hurt you. And he will say to you, where is your God? Let your God save you. You are hungry? Let your God feed you. Oh, you don't have money to pay for your electric bill? Oh, Christian Prince, you cannot fix your heater? You are dying from freezing? How come God cannot send you money? The devil, he will try to play with your mind to make you believe that you are left alone. But look, our church father, they've been given as food to animals, and they never betray Christ. I mean, sometimes I think about them, how much faith they have. They are amazing. I mean, they bring you to a cage, have a lion, and they say, okay, say I don't believe in Jesus, I will let you go. They say, no, send me. Even the Quran mention a story of the Christians in Yemen. And supposedly this is about a king who is a Jew. He came to the territory and he burned all the Christians alive. This is in chapter 85, verse number 4. And he asked them, the believers who believe in Jesus, to deny Jesus. And they refuse. So history witnessed for us. Christianity is built and protected by the true believers, not by numbers. Not by numbers. This is why those terrorists, they fear us, and we are few. I mean, how many Christians they go online fighting the cult of Muhammad? You can count them by your fingers. They fear those who you can by fingers more than all the Christians, who are more than 3 billion. Is that a true story? I cannot really confirm if this is a true story or not, but mostly everything have a smoke, you know, it's a smoke of a fire somewhere, which means, like, you know, in the Middle East we say if there's no fire, there's no smoke, if there's no smoke, there's no fire, etc. So it possibly that something happened like this to certain Christians in Yemen. I cannot confirm in history anything, but this is what it says. Right? Anyway, yeah, this is why when you are a true believer, Satan, he fear you. And this is why he target you. You see, let us say there's a criminal. He want to go and he want to take over. He killed first who? He killed those who can defend first. Because if we strip you from the defense, we can take over, right? So he fear the one who defend, not the others who they are asleep. There's many Christians are just asleep. I mean, even if you try to talk to them about Islam and anything, they say, hey, we don't want to talk about God. Please don't, you know. You go with your friend, you try that. And they claim that they are Christians. They go to church, their family go to church. The second you start talking about God, let us read a verse from the Bible. They say, this is what are you talking about? We're doing coffee here, you know. Don't waste our time. They're Christian by name. They don't want to talk. Well, when people, they sit together, when family, they visit family, what they do? All kind of talk, but nothing serious and nothing real. Oh, where are you again? I did my hair. Oh, where you did your hair? Oh, I did it with this guy. He is very good. Okay, that's the conversation. What is the benefit of this visit? What we, you know, social is very important. But social is meant that we exchange things. This is what social is. We exchange. And the best exchange a human being does is exchange knowledge. I learn from you learn from me. Otherwise, if I am going to a place and we spend the time saying nothing, doing nothing, we learn what? You know, if I have a friend, let us say one of you, like, you know, we go to drink coffee. Me, because I spend the whole day speaking serious, I would like in the coffee time not to ask me anything about the garbage of Muhammad. I am an exception. But you understand why, right? Honestly, if I go with you, I hate it when people, they start saying to me things I said in YouTube or etc. I don't want that, you know. Please just give me a break. But this is an exception because I spend too much time talking about this garbage. So leave the garbage to the place of the garbage. And again, I wish one day I will wake up in the morning and I will say to myself, I am not going to talk about this garbage no more. I did enough. Christians, they have thousands and thousands of videos and they have books. But that day is not coming yet. I will do as much as I can. And for sure, we appreciate those people who support us, even they are few. But the few is good. And always, the good are few, not the majority. Yeah, actually, this is why I made a quality of life account, so I will not talk about the garbage of Muhammad. And then there I say, don't talk about Islam there. Please don't talk about it, because that's it. I need a break. I need a wife. No, my friend. I think that will not be, that will be even will make it worse. Because if I have a wife, I will not be here now. I assure you, if I have a wife, I will not be able to be here. Maybe in the beginning she said to you, honey, no problem, I support you. But first day, second day, her she would have a headache. I mean, how long I'm here now? Suppose this is a short video, right? So she can take it first day, second day, third day. A week after, she will call her mother, and then they will come, both of them, with high heels, and then they will publish in the news that this guy was found, dead, by high heels injury, like Muhammad. Yeah. And then they will put a picture of a guy, he have high heels in his head, you know. And underneath, CNN will say, this is what happened to you when you disrespect women. Da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da, you know? Yeah. I mean, it's very it's true. It's true, very true, you know? It's like, you know, like you are a cowboy, you know? And, you know, you can imagine what will happen next, you know? Like, just think about it. Just think about it. You know? Yeah. That's not easy. Choose, you know? I mean, and they are, this is why these days, I mean, if you notice how thin those high heels they are and how long. I mean, it's really terrifying, man. What is that for? Is that a shoe? Is that for real? It doesn't look like a shoe. Like the story of guy, in the ship, you know, the ship destroying. This is a true story, brother, by the way, Sahih Bukhari. The ship, you know, a drone, and then they wanted nails to build a new ship. Guess what? There's a lot of ladies was in the cruise ship. So they use their high heels to make a new ship, brother. True story. You know? I mean, there is many witnesses for this story. If you don't, in case you don't believe me, what's wrong with you? You guys don't believe it, don't you? Yeah, even women, when they go to get their wedding day, I mean, they make it the highest they can. And the guy in front of her, the husband, he have no idea what he is going to face very soon. You got what you asked for. Like, hello. Good for you. All right. So I want to say thank you for being here. May the Lord bless you all. And we'll see you soon again. Christ is Lord. Islam is false. And humbly, this is your brother, Christian Prince. Was with you, and again we appreciate those who support us. I see very little people they are helping in the donation. I don't talk about it, but I noticed that for some reason, I don't know, maybe because of Corona, maybe, I'm not sure, but we appreciate those who support us, and we will be always happy to meet you and see you and do the much, I mean, the best we can do. Thank you. God bless. Take care. And don't worry about the high heels, but I was joking, okay? I mean, come on, women, they will not use it. These days, they use their nails. Hello? I mean, who care for the shoes? That's propaganda. This is fake news. Those are not for any reason bad. Those are good. Just worry about their nails. Did you see how long their nails? Anyway, I don't want to talk about it. I'm scared already. All right. Take care. God bless. Bye-bye.